I've been on a bit of a kick with making new sectorials while I get ready for my tournaments. That, by the time you're watching this, has already passed. Hey guys, it's Ryan, and this week we're going to make a video about the ultimate Pano sectorial. The sectorial that is so Pano-Oceanian, it's got fosters with karhus and crosses out the wazoo. I'm going to go through Pano units and pick those that are the most Pano-Oceanian and throw them into one sectorial and see what we come up with. If you have any ideas on this, let me know in the comments below, and remember to like and subscribe for more. So how do I define the ultimate Pano sectorial? Is everything just BS14 plus and no whip? Well, yes, but also no. The idea here is I look for common roles in Pano and look at the units from sectorials that match that role and pick which is the best or feels like it belongs in the ultimate Pano sectorial. Let's give an example. Well, the obvious ones are line troopers, main battle tags, but the less obvious ones are Pano's elite non-heavy infantry shooters. You know, the MSV snipers who link with machinists and get seriously high BS, Bolts, Bagmari, Nisei and Kamau. You might think the karhu counts, but they don't get their own pure core, breadth of profiles, nor do they get that machinist buddy. So they don't count here, and neither does a Black Friar for the same reasons. Once I have these roles, how do I pick the most Pano unit? To be honest, it's mostly vibes. I look at what fits the archetype best, what fits the stereotype better than the rest, and finally who gives the most coverage for this sectorial. The goal of the unit is to have big guns, shoot well, and be high tech. One of the targets of this video is to get to 26 units. This will be accomplished by a lot of different categories to pick from and including any characters that count as the selected units, such as Patsy with Orcs, Kyle with Knight Hospitallers, and the many Fusilier Indigo opt for Fusiliers. Looking at what I have now, we have 19 categories to run through, ranging from disposable troopers to main battle tags. Now, I won't always just have one picked from a category, as some we usually get two from the list, such as two light battle tags or two forward deploying light infantry. It is kind of arbitrary on what will get it, but I will explain my logic as we go through. Finally, as I said, this video is entirely arbitrary, and you may have your own categories within Pano Sectorials, and you may have your own choices. If you do, then let me know down in the comments below, because I would really like to read and respond to them. Now, let's pick some units. Line troopers are our first choice, and we have three to choose from, and some solid options. The Akon Regulars, who are cooler Fusiliers, Fusiliers, and Croziers and Knight Commanders. We're grouping those last two together because the Knight Commander is just a super LT line trooper. The Akon Regulars are first and, as I mentioned, are basically cooler Fusiliers with a jungle vibe and some minor profile differences that boil down to them being really cool with the Spitfire, Fast Panda on the Hacker with a grenade launcher for some really efficient SWC usage, and the big one is the Sapper Multi-Sniper Rifle loadout. They stand out not only as cooler looking Fusiliers, but equally as practical, but somewhat different. Croziers and Knight Commanders are not as broad as Regulars or Fusiliers, but they get the BS and Whip 12, which is very Pano. To make up for this, they get a banging 22-point MSV2 Spitfire profile, who honestly might be the cheapest high-tech shooter in the game. We also get some Blitzens and EM Mines, which are very nicely Pano by the way of diversification via tech. The Knight Commander has Hollow Mask and a +1 Lieutenant order with Whip 13, which is probably one of Pano-Oceania's best Lieutenant. His BS-13 and Light Shotgun has made a good few mad dashes that are really fun. Finally are the Fusiliers, who are in 3 of the 5 Pano Sectorials and 2/3 of the in-production ones. They get a huge amount of kit compared to other line garrison troopers. Combi rifles, grenade launchers, HMGs, missile launchers, multi-sniper rifles, hackers, forward observers with deployable repeaters and paramedics. They say Aguaseals were the first unit ever made, but damn it, Corvus Belli nailed line troopers with Fusiliers. So who is the most Pano line trooper? And you're thinking it's Fusiliers, I'm thinking it's Fusiliers, we're all thinking it's Fusiliers, but I'm going to pick the Akon Regulars instead, because as I said this entire time, they're cooler Fusiliers. No HMG, but you get everything you need and a little extra. I've called this category disposable troopers, but really it's garrison troopers and the tech bee, so that is the auxilia, helots, and tech bees. The last one only because it needed to be somewhere. Auxilia, I think, are a well-designed disposable unit, and if they had good CC or an SMG rather than a combi, I'd argue this is Pano's warband. Auxilia are great corner guards at 14 points with two bodies with a heavy flamethrower and a combi rifle and BS-11. It makes attacking Pano a real pain beyond just throwing high ballistic skill at problems, and it becomes a really nice trading piece. Helots are both really Pano and not really Pano at the same time. Still, BS-11 for a cheap and irregular trooper who can delay and dissuade via some assaults. Neurocinetics is an odd one but very much Pano, since that you can leave the active to the tags and have the helots die for them in the reactive. Not directly very Pano, but very much supporting it through firepower in the reactive turn. Tech bees are the last one and an odd one, as the cheapest specialist in the game at 5 points with whip 12 irregular and only a flash pulse with no main gun. Weirdly a gizmo kit as well, not an engineer but a specialist nonetheless. I make good use of them often enough, so always worth considering them. So which one am I picking? Honestly, it's the auxilia. It's close. One, we need an Oxbot user, and two, I think they're pretty good disposable cheap lower end units that stays utterly Pano. And to be fair, it was close with the Helots, who I think are also a staple of vanilla Pano. Elite light infantry are those who are light infantry and more expensive and slightly more specialised in their role. Our two examples are blockers and order sergeants, and bring better hackers, better static combis, heavy rocket launchers, and Oxbots. Blockers are just hackers, but also a weird burst 3 ADHL or burst 4 multi-pistols in a fire team. Order sergeants' ability to join croziers and bring their own corner guard separately makes them so reliable, and honestly, if this had a burst 4 gun and like one other trick, this would stand out in any other faction, but in military order, it's just there as a regular trooper. Blockers are very similar, acting as a way for a cheap but useful member to help supercharge the Bolt fire team or discover on 22s for Fusiliers. They get a lot of side graded equipment, which I think is really neat. So who do I pick? Well, I think if I had Croziers as my line trippers, Order Sergeants would be the ones I'd pick, but I don't, so I'm going for Blockers. Order Sergeants also lose out by the fact that we have Auxilia. If we had Helots, I'd swap them in here. I think they're mildly better, but for what will become of this sectorial, I think the blocker is slightly more in theme. Our advanced deploying light infantry is a mouthful, but it starts to speak of Pano's lesser known faction niche that it serves with Hack Islam. It's bloody good light infantry. We get these infiltrating parachutists and forward deployment pieces to act as a vanguard, with some really solid or painful pieces that, if we go first, or even if you go second and place them well, can do a lot of damage. We have five choices who I'll get into, and here I'm going to pick two. Why two? Well, every Pano Sectorial except Military Order and Shock Army of Acansamento, which is very old, have two units that fit this description. Echo Bravos are the odd one out, as they're an airborne deployment trooper, but they fit a very similar role and bring fantastic kit that really helps Verd and would be a boon to any Pano Sheen army. So, they're here for consideration. Blades are just amazing units and instantly modernize NCA overnight. They are arguably the best engineers in Pano and have a really good forward deployment version that could, while less useful, be absolutely dangerous and hunt down hackers and pick up some objectives. Knock-ins are really stacked Pano forward deploying light infantry with forward deployment plus 8 inches with min-6 and BS-12. It rocks so many nice options that you really could have something for every occasion, or just take the Spitfire and murder things. The Zulu Cobra does this as well, but with less options, more guns, better BS, and camo over just OOD. They have some iconic loadouts and are often seen as acting as NCA and Verd's skirmishers. Now, Beast Hunters aren't native to Pano, but they get a pass since they have a Pano-specific faction loadout. That being the Heavy Flamethrower plus 1 burst in camo, which is a really nice and adds a nasty little surprise under a camel marker. The two I think belong in a best pano sectorial is the blade for just modernizing a sectorial overnight and bringing so much to fire teams with tags. In terms of forward deploying light troopers, it's not best in slot, but it does need to show up. The second one is another piece I really like, and it's the knock-in. It's often maligned for its lack of camo, but also often called a better bulleteer, and the hacker, killer hacker, and spitfire, and forward observer profiles can do a lot of cards. Drop troopers are exactly what they sound like, entirely airborne troopers. We have three innate pano options, with the Knight of Santiago not counting, as that's only one profile. First, we have the Echo Bravo again. Should it be here? Probably not, but I want it here, so it is. It doesn't have a similar loadout to the other ones, using a Red Fury instead of a Spitfire, and its boarding shotgun and light rocket launcher are unique, but it's still broadly the same, even down to price and ballistic skill. The Achilles and Kerpel are next and represent good medium infantry drop troopers. Yes, that was a pointed comment. They are as pano as drop troopers go. Good BS, decent gun selections, specialists and spitfires. Now, Crusaders have one pano advantage over the Achilles. They have multi-weapons and templates and are somehow point for point more expensive than the other two. It's just not great. So it's not you, Crusader. I do like you and will use you in military order, but it won't mean I'm not green with envy. So who am I picking? I like Kerpel and his lads, but I think I like the unique loadouts in the Echo Bravo more, so we're picking that. Fake Skirmishers are another weirdly good pano light infantry archetype. It is another weird staple of pano. So what counts? Well, basically it's a unit with camo or hidden deployment and maybe some form of forward deployment. Basically, if you look at it and go, this is a skirmisher but marked as light infantry, well then that's it, and we have two, the Zulu Cobras again and the Hexes. I've already discussed the Zulu Cobras, so I'll be quick. They are very skirmishy. Basically, with infiltration, they'd be skirmishers through and through. One thing they have is that jammer and sensor profiles for proper board control and can shut down most threats with some smart plays. The addition of breaker weapons is also really nice and allows a wider swath of targets. Hexes are the second fake skirmisher and only miss infiltration off of what is otherwise a really standard but solid hidden deployment skirmisher, and in terms of profiles it's really simple but utilitarian with spitfires, multi-sniper rifles, hacking devices and killer hacking devices for which are all around 26 to 30 points. They're iconic pano units. So which is the most pano? Honestly, could be either, but I'm going with Zulu Cobras because I like the option it gives us. One reason in particular was the jammer profile that just gives pano so much board control, which we lack outside of ARO pieces. Pano's elite shooters are the iconic light infantry and medium infantry of pano that do one thing and one thing only. Make a pure core or Harris and just pick a direction and blast it with an MSV multi-sniper rifle. Such stunning alumni are the Kamau, Bolts, Nisi and Bagmare. If it can't be pure cored and doesn't get a machinist buddy, it doesn't count. Sorry, Karhu. I think this is maybe one of the tightest roles we've talked about so far. So describing the difference while useful, well, there is not a lot between them. More than the line troopers, but less. So it's still very tight. So all three are BS-13 except the Bagmare, all have min-3 except the Bolt, all have hacker profiles, all have MSV at least one on the sniper profile, which enables the big pano sniper tower. Bolts only get MSV1 on the one profile, Kamaus get MSV2. All have paramedics and secondary specialists except the Nisei, they just get the paramedics and hackers. All have a burst 4 gun. Bolts get Spitfires, and everything else gets HMGs. Thus far, it's a flavour choice on what you want, but each one's gimmick is powerful. Nisei's are MSV2 and min-3 on all profiles, making it a dependable shooter. Kamau's get stealth and good BTS with better visor on the sniper. Bagmare get mine layers, and finally, Bolts get the most options, chain of command and marksmanship, making them the most dangerous sniper in the game. With that, it is obvious who I'm going to pick as the ultimate pano elite shooter. It's the Bolts with a potential BS-19 to hit a target in cover for 128 points. That is amazing, and that is part of the reason why we are the shooting faction. The only issue here is MSV1, although if someone dares to try it with min-6 or albedo, a core of Bolts will right them rightly. Supporting shooters are those who do not have the breadth of options like our elite shooters, but still bring new options to the table that are needed or enjoyed by the faction. Pano examples are the Vargar, Blackfriars, and Karhu. Now, let's not pretend it's not Blackfriars. It could have been Vargars, but it's obviously going to be the Karhus. The plus one burst Fjordback and MSV1 on everything is basically Pano Shiania to a T. Line heavy infantry are those heavy infantry that are basic and cover a lot of roles for main guns, ARL pieces, and specialist options. Bulkier light infantry, basically, and you'll know exactly what I mean when I say Mobile Brigada, Jans, and Zhuyongs. However, Pano has really two, or one and two halves. Our choices are the venerable orcs and the equally nasty knight hospitallers, who are basically orcs with frenzy, slower, and melee, and also the Teutonic Knight, who act as the combined line heavy infantry of military orders. Orcs, I think, are one of the best line troopers in the game, just due to their variety of options and simplicity in usage. Do you want a two-wound shotgun? We have that. Do you want it with stealth and a tinny? Go for it. Want it with climbing plus? Absolutely. It has a HMG and multi-weapons, and even a hacker for specialist options. All on arm 4, viz 14 and 6-2. But for peak Pano, it's got absolutely devastating Fjordbacks. Knight Hospitallers do a lot of what the Orcs do, but differently. They get Doctors instead of Hackers, BTS-6 and WHIP-13 over WHIP-12 and BTS-3. They lack the big guns, but they're all shock, all assault. Really solid, but they don't link or have the big ARO guns that Orcs do. We have to look into the Teutonic Knights, who get Missile Launchers, Tin Bots and Specialists, but has a big Pano Sin. It's only BS-13. So who should be the ultimate Pano line heavy infantry? I mean, we skipped the obvious one earlier with the line light infantry, so now we won't. It's the orcs, as they just epitomize Pano with good BS, meh whip, and plenty of options. Despite not being the heavy infantry faction, Pano heavy infantry has always been quite good. Assault heavy infantry are those that's goal is to close the distance and deal some damage. We'll be picking two here, which is padding the numbers out a bit, but I also wanted some variety in the sectorial. Knight Hospitallers have already been mentioned, so I won't reiterate what I said, but they are good at close range with melee and shotguns, and they bring two nice characters. The introduction of the motorized Knight of Montessa has given Pano a really good tool to punish null deployment. Sure, it's hackable, as is the Peacemaker, but this one is arm 4 and min minus 3, and is remarkably durable with the two wounds. It is fantastic at its job, and it shows up in 3 out of the 5 Pano Shianian sectorials, which is impressive for any heavy infantry. It does a lot of what the Knight Hospitaller does in the assault role, but it does it faster and more angrily. The Guardo di Assalto is our first guard unit, and it's showing its age, but it is ultimately a BS-15 gun with an oxbot, heavy flamethrower, and is quick and a very good shot for cheap. Basic, yes, but pretty fun and effective, and has Pano's only smoke. Which two am I picking? Well, I am biased, but it's the two knights. They just work so well as assault heavy infantry, and then Montessa is basically a Pano staple with it being so prolific. Hospitallers show up in Svalharema and MO, and I think bring great results in those sectorials. Our final heavy infantry choice, and it's truly iconic for Pano, is the Guard. What is a guard? Because it's not the skill, it's a BS-15 heavy infantry who acts as Pano's upper end of non-tag firepower. Joan is not a guard in name and more a named Knight Hospitaller, but also very much is as a BS-15 elite heavy infantry, so that's why she's here. In terms of niches of the guard, she is the leader guard with inspiring leadership and whip 15. She is here to lead and to do lots of damage in melee or shooting, and is damn durable with 2.5 wounds. She is the Pano mascot and shows up all the time in military orders and Pano Shiania. She is a quick and deadly assault piece on top of being the face of Pano. Perfect propaganda. Swiss and Aquila Guard, we'll need to group these two together since they both represent NCA, and I'd like to say they're two sides of the same coin, kinda. One rocks the best anti-camo kit in the game, BS-15 and MSV-3, just to make anything from Ariadna to Hack Islam squirm. Inversely, one of the best camo units in the game by some metrics is the Swiss Guard, a full-on ARM 5 missile launcher or HMG or multi-rifle with a hacking device, all in hidden deployment with two wounds, just to really mess someone up who thought they were safe. Guarda di Assalto I mentioned before, but compared to the other three guards, it's looking fairly quaint. It's not got the CQC of Joan or the firepower of NCA. If it was to come back, which I believe it should, it really needs to get a bit of an update. So who is the ultimate guard for Pano? Which one of the three? Now Joan is great and the face of Pano as a whole, but I think we need some more firepower and need some MSV just to show off how high tech we are. So I'm going to go with the Aquila and the Swiss Guard, because there is no kill like overkill. Speaking of, the main pieces of Pano we care about is the tags, specifically the main battle tags. We have five choices: the Squallow, Drago, Jotun, Cutter, and kind of the Surf. All are BS-15 and all but the Surf is Arm 8 and Silhouette 7. The Surf is on the council of main battle tags but not a member. With these minor differences, it's a bit more nuanced in points. So like the Fusilier is to the Aguacil, the Squallow is to every other main battle tag. Better at shooting, but not as bright. Nothing fancy beyond its Hacker EMC -3, and Varuna options with a Zapper and Multi-Pistol. It's basic, it's good at shooting with its Multi-HMG, NCO options, and a grenade launcher to turn it into a literal artillery piece. You cannot hide from the Heavy Lancer. The Salamander, Zeta, and Bulltrack are widely respected units for being able to loose 5 shots on any target without a fireteam. Well, do you want to do that better? Well, in that case, we have the Drago, a BS-15 heavy flamethrower and hyper-rapid magnetic cannon main battle tag. We could say, yes, the Zeta has climbing plus, the overdrawn and the bull track is cheaper, and the Salamander is better shielded against hackers. But I think it's absolutely peak Pano just for the biggest gun in the game on the best shooter in the game. Do you want a more basic Squallow that is both literally and metaphorically a slab of metal? Then Pano has that tag with the Jotun. What's more superior than being able to peek from cover and being able to ignore combi and marksman rifles, since you would effectively be Arm 13, becoming the reason that you need AP in a list? It is common throughout the community that the tag is a problem. And mimetism is a problem to deal with, and the Sphinx is actually good. Hard disagree, but in Pano, we have a good Sphinx, and that is the Cutter, and it is one of the most dangerous tags in the games, thanks to it being safe with camo and even hidden deployment until you want to show up and shoot something, imposing a -9 while you take your shots on BS-15. The Cutter is the top of Pano's firepower food chain, and the only things that can hold it off are an MSV sniper, riot girls, or maybe the Marut. Now, the Surf is not as strong as a shooter as even the Squallow, but oh boy do I still think it has legs. Largely down to its legs, the super jumping legs, no less. So it can bounce up the board with a cute little friend with a strong HMG or Spitfire. Unfortunately, no AP, but when you want to remove something really tough, just use melee. That's right, it's got a CC 23, damage 17, explosive CCW. That will cleave through most things. It's not Pano shooting, but it is still Pano overkill. So who is the most Pano main battle tag? The most Pano role in the game? Well, it's a tough one because any one of the first four is absolutely Pano. But in terms of raw firepower, I'm going to have to go with the Drago because it is so blunt and just so much gun that I kind of just want it here as the ultimate gun piece. The Cutter is probably better, but I wanted to leave the more fancy stuff to the lighter battle tags. But if you wanted to pick it, you'd be absolutely correct. In a lot of faction, light battle tags, or LBTs, tend to shoot things about as well as a main battle tag, but usually a bit worse. We don't tend to have that issue in Pano, as all our tags are natively BS-15. Max is 14, but really he's an Aleph loner, but he's also Captain Pano, so he counts as one of ours. LBTs, to make up for lack of shooting, usually have skills like camo, climbing plus, or other abilities, or are fairly cheap. But in Pano, we get those and keep the decent shooting. In this section, I'll be picking two here because we usually have two light tags these days. Maximus is Captain Pano, and it's kind of bittersweet that the first character tag since Tony, and it's an Aleph native, which I could forgive, but the BS-14 is still something I need time on. He's fairly prolific in Pano with Vard, Swalharema and NCA, and he's kind of become a Pano staple as our second melee tag, and offers good melee defense for many Sectorials that kind of need it. The Squallow Mark II is the Squallow in miniature in many ways. Same-ish stats but lighter, same profiles but less, basically all the same firepower, except it has two pistols rather than one because it's the cowboy and reinforcement tag. I really like this one, and I even have one even if I don't play reinforcements, NCA or Vert. I apply all the good points from the Squallow, but only about like 80% of them. Now, the Teak Belang has two faces, the Military Order and the Akon Teak. For this section, I'll only be considering the Akon Teak, and while it is the lesser Teak, it is not a bag tag, as it is still a Climbing Plus HMG on BS15 with a Heavy Flamethrower and even Shock Mines, just to be a pain to anyone. Just in case you thought I was done, it's also got min-3, which is great on a tag. It is a really solid one at that, and getting a new model in August. Now, this is a divisive tag. Some say it's too expensive, others say it has too much firepower, and I've gone from the former to the latter. The Ulan is a Fuhrback +1 burst tag with a HMG on BS15. Not only that, it's got the min-3 like the Teak, but it's also got a camo on a tag, which is amazing. While not as mimetic as the Cutter, it is pretty good to lob out 3 shots with AP plus DA and just slay almost anything it faces, including other tags, really easily. It is truly a tank hunter. So who do I pick? Well, I have two choices, and the first one, and the reason why I didn't take the Cutter, it is the Ulan, because it is a really technical and a really firepower oriented piece. Perfectly Pano. Secondly, I'm going for Max, because he's a character tag, and what's more Pano-Shianian than a character tag? Pano skirmishers aren't as cheap as other factions, but they usually do the job well enough, and with BS-12, it can effectively tussle in the midfield, and we have 3 to pick from. Trinitarians are one of my favourite skirmishers and are relatively new as far as Pano-Shianian units go. They're devilishly cheap, effective and good enough skirmishers that I don't know if I would call them Pano-Shianian, but limited in profiles, with basically only being able to be forward observers with the choice of SMGs or boarding shotguns and maybe a mine layer or sniper rifles, which is neat, but that's not unique. However, I have gotten so much return on investment from that SMG profile, it's criminal. Crocmen are Trins but more premium and with more options. They get X-Visors and the ability to be hackers or a forward observer with access to rifles, which is absolutely needed on a skirmisher in my opinion. They do also get that sniper, and all profiles have shock mines but sit around the 30 point mark for a really effective Hind deployment trooper. Oh, and Hind deployment hacking is hilarious and evil. Locusts are more similar to Knockin with min-6 and no camo, but they're a profile definitely from an older time with CC20, which is not really impressive, but it actually runs good weapons such as breaker combis, D-charges, drop bears and shock marksman rifles. We also get a selection of hacker profiles, which again is very nice. This is overall a strong midfield fighter, but I think you need another skirmisher unit to support this. I think I want the Crocmen in my ultimate Pano sector because they have much better coverage of what I want in a skirmisher and are capable as solo PCs sans support, which is how I personally use my skirmishers. For the sake of brevity, I've skipped some unit selections, but here is the complete sectorial now. All those that were mentioned before, but also the Knight of the Holy Sepulchre, Knight of Santiago, Dart, Shona, Agnes and Uma. Additionally, we also have the characters that are part of other units such as the Orcs with Patsy, Defernzen and Kyle for the Knight Hospitallers. That will comfortably get us to a pack sectorial with 26 unique profiles before we include such things as the Remotes, Tramadocs and Machinists, firmly in the range of a modern sectorial. So let's briefly talk about fire teams. The fire teams for this ultimate sectorial are rather boring since they are basically the Pano default ones for its sectorials. It's the light infantry one with some orcs and medium infantry that can join it. It's the medium infantry one with machinists and one random elite trooper. The orc fire team with a random light infantry slash medium infantry. A wildcard one that can be anything. Finally, a tag fire team and a wealth of solid wildcards. So let's start with the regular fire team. Like most other fire teams, the Akon regular fire team is kind of a copy and paste from its OG sectorial. However, if you look at Svalharima, NCA and Verd, Fusilier fire teams, it's basically the same thing with sectorial specific stuff swapped out. In this fire team, we get a Harris or Core with 1 to 5 regulars, 0 to 2 orcs, blockers can come in counting as regulars and at 0 to 2, and finally 0 to 2 bolts in the same way they do in NCA and Bagmari do in Akon. A Pano standard fire team, and I can see it being built purely for BS15 sapper snipers, or you can bring in a bolt or an orc for bigger, although impure guns. A bolt fire team is like its NCA counterpart with duos, Harris and Core options with 1 to 5 bolts with a blocker and machinist counting as bolts. It's like NCA and it's here to specifically do the same thing, get BS19 and dominate the board. Literally peak Pano. While jealous of Orcs' options as a military orders player, I am not at all jealous of their fire teams since they're usually quite basic. Duo Harris and Core options with 1 to 5 Orcs, 0 to 2 Karhu, and 1 Blade fire team option that can count as Orcs. No one really does full Orc pain trains, but the options are here for something really solid, and this is the equivalent to NCA, Akon, and Verd Orcs. Night fire teams are equally as boring, as Night Hospitallers don't always get good fire teams. Certainly the MO1s aren't great, and Svalharima is fine. It's only a dual Harris setup, which is where I think the Night Hospitaller are best, with blades that can pop along, and Defernsen and Kyle can come in here and count as pure. As an assault heavy infantry, they are here to move up providing fire and then get close and stab things with their swords, characters, and wild cards. Final fire team is the overkill fire team, and that is the tag fire team, letting Dragos or Max fire team duel with each other, or a Montessa, or any of the wild cards, including Shona or the Blade fire team option, which is a really good classic Pano duel. Finally is the wild cards. Pano doesn't get any real bangers, but it does get some outstanding ones in the Knight of Santiago, Bulleteer, Karhu, and Blade fire team options. But what's the breakdown overall? All but the Santiago are availability 1, the Blade FTO counts as bolt, Uma counts as a regular and bolts, the Defernsen can count as an orc like Patsy, who can also count as a Knight Hospitaller, which is a small boost to them. Other wild cards are Agnes for cheapness, Shona for melee, the Aquila FTO for just flexing on Camel Faction in true Pano power. So many amazing wild cards available to Pano, or well, there is if you literally pick the best of the best. So that was my video on the Ultimate Pano Sectorial. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and let me know what you think I should do next. Please do not pick Yuzhing, I have literally no idea what their thing is, but I could maybe try the other factions. Anyway, remember to like and subscribe for more, and thank you so much for watching.